Very good afternoon, students. Welcome to the another session of Irrigation and Hydraulic Structures subject. In the previous class, we have discussed about how to draw a mass inflow curve and how a demand curve or respective mass inflow curve is discussed. And also, we have learned about how to use mass inflow curve in the determination of storage capacity of a reservoir. What are the how to draw the mass inflow curve, demand curve, so that we can calculate what is the storage capacity of a reservoir. So in the calculation of storage capacity of a reservoir, we have discussed that the highest ordinate means whatever the shortfall is drawn in the mass inflow curve, that is considered as your highest ordinate, is considered as your required storage capacity of a reservoir. Okay, so now here let us take an example of one problem so that we can understand how a storage capacity of a reservoir or required capacity of a reservoir to store the water can be assessed by a numerical example. So let us go to the problem now. Now here in this particular slide you can see what is the inflow values given in the problem, as well as how our inflow values are converted into cumulative values. Let us see. Here, three different seasons like monsoon, winter, as well as summer. So, in these three seasons, the different inflow values are given. Right? So, these inflow values are given for a particular 12 years data. So, each year, there is three different monsoons and three different monsoons for 12 years. So total 3 year, 3 monsoon data for different years, like 12 years data is given. Now here he is asking in the question that we have to maintain a inflow of 475 Qsecs in the reservoir. To store this 475 Qsecs of water in the reservoir, what is the required storage capacity in the reservoir? That we have to determine by using mass inflow curve. So let us go into the details. So these are the inflow values given. So here what we have to do is we have to assume, like, three different season values are given, inflow values are given. So for each season we have to give naming. Like, I am giving the naming for the first one. What is the first period here? 16th June to 30th September. So for this I am going to give M as the abbreviation. So M means monsoon, and the second one we are considering it as winter, which is denoted with W, and the third season we are considering it as summer, so let us denote it with S. So similarly, let us move on to the next slide. Now here what we have to calculate is the calculation of the accumulated values. Accumulated results should be calculated. So how to calculate these accumulated values? So we have to draw a tabular column so that all the values are segregated at one place, and after segregating we have to convert the cumens into the million hectometers, because whatever the mass inflow curve which we are going to plot, that will be representing in two values. One is on y axis we are going to represent million hectometers, so that is the volume is indicated in such units. In similar fashion, on x-axis, we are going to take the time, means in years. So, for the respective years, what is the accumulated volume of water? So, that we have to plot as a mass inflow curve. So, after plotting the mass inflow curve, what we have to do? We have to calculate the demand curve also on the same scale. So, first, let us calculate the accumulated values of inflows. In a similar fashion, let us calculate the mass demand curve also. So, for calculating this mass inflow curve, so we need to convert cumex to million hectometers. So, how to convert that? Let us see. Right, before that, as I already told you, we have to give a noting. Right, monsoon is abbreviated with M, whereas similarly, winter with W and summer with S. So, in each of these seasons, there is a specified interval of time given. In that period, how many number of days are coming? Right? So if you see, in the monsoon season, we are getting 107 days. And in the next winter season we are getting 182 days. Similarly, in the summer season we are getting 72 days. Now let us convert. In each of these we have different flows in terms of Q6 minutes. So now let us multiply this Q6 with the number of days, and also we have to convert the cubic meters per second to cubic meters per day. Right? So to convert that cubic meters per second into cubic meters per day, what we have to do? We have to multiply it with some factor. That factor is 86,400. So if you multiply the Q-max into 86,400 and also the number of days, we will be getting these values in terms of hectometers. Right? So we have to convert into hectometers also. Now let us see how to convert these values. Now moving on to the next slide. See, in this particular slide, you can see I have noted down the serial numbers and the respective years. The years which are given as 1960 to 1972. So during these years, we need to calculate. Now, in each year, we have three seasons. So again, in three seasons, each one is varying with number of days. Like 107, 182 and 76. Right, 182, 76 as well as 107. So these are the days according to the seasons. Now what we have to do? We have to multiply this cubic flows. Cubic values are given, right? That discharge is given. For example, if you take monsoon season, number of days are 107. So these 107, each second, how much volume of, how much discharge of water is coming into the reservoir? It is coming as 1050. Now, in order to convert this 1050 cubics into what? Million hectometers. So we have to multiply this 1050 with 107, the number of days, and also to convert this into million hectometers, what we have to do? Per day calculation we require. So we will multiply 1050 with 107, then after multiplying with 1050 with 107, then multiply with the number of working days, number of days in the monsoon, 107 and 1050. So after that, you need to multiply with 86,400, which is the conversion of cubics to day. So 3 are multiplied, 1050 into 107 into 86,400. So after multiplying this, you will get some value. Now this value, you need to convert it into million hectometers. So how to convert it into million hectometers? Now it is in cubics, cubics per day. Now, in order to convert cubics per day into cubic meters per day into, right, we need to take the value of what we have to consider. We have to divide this value with 10,000, because 10,000 cubic meters is equal to 1 hectometers. Now, we will divide this value with 10,000. After dividing with 10,000, the value is, it is now hectometers per day. That is the inflow. Now after converting this, what we have to do? We have to again divide with this hectometers per day into million hectometers. So for that, we have to divide it with 10 lakhs. So after that, whatever the value we are seeing, that is the value. It is 0.9707. That is the value after conversion. Cubics is simultaneously converted into what? Million hectometers per day. That is the conversion values. So similarly, we will convert all the values. Let us assume we have converted for all the seasons and all the years. So similarly, what we have to do? We have to calculate the accumulated values. So these accumulated values, how we have to calculate? We have to calculate based on the addition, number of addition. For example, in the first one, it is 0.9707. So similarly, in the second one, we have to add first column as well as the total one, and in the second next column. So simultaneously we have to add for every column, each and every column. So at the end, the ultimate value calculated will be like this. It is 29.4570. So what is this 29.4570? It is the volume of water which is accumulated at the end of the year, that is in the year 1972 71 to 72. So at the end of year 72, this is the amount of volume accumulated, 29.4570 million hectometers per day. So this is the conversion value, right? Now we got this value, right? How we have converted? By converting into cubics into cubic meters, then cubic meters into number per day values. Per day values is multiplied with number of working days, and again we are dividing this cubics per day with hectometers, which we have to divide with 10,000. And similarly, after dividing that, million hectometers is converted by dividing with 10 lakhs. So similarly, we have to calculate for the remaining also. Now this is the 29.4570 is the final accumulated inflow in terms of million hectometers per day. Okay, now let us move on to the next slide. After this, what we have to do, we need to calculate the mass demand curve. So how to calculate the mass demand curve? This mass demand curve is calculated based on the what? It is the number of working days and what is the inflow. So what is the inflow we are expecting? It is clear in the question that we have to maintain a 475 cubics. Okay, 475 cubic meters per second we have to maintain in the reservoir for a period of 365 days, 1 year. So multiply 465 with 365 days, and also you can multiply with 8.64, which is directly conversion factor into hectometers. Okay, now after that we got the value as 14,97,960 hectometers. Now hectometers to what we have to do? We have to convert it into million hectometers. So divide with 10 lakhs, you will be getting 1.49 million hectometers. So it is almost close to the 1.5 million hectometers. So now let us consider this as the demand, constant demand for a year. Now after this, what we have to do? We have to plot the mass inflow curve with the accumulated inflow values, and on the same scale we need to plot the mass demand curve also. Right, now how to draw? Let us see in the picture. Now this is the picture. So this picture, what happens here? Whatever the curve you are seeing, that curve is indicating the accumulated mass inflow values in terms of million hectometers. On the y-axis you can see the time, on y-axis you can see the time, on x-axis you can see, on y-axis you can observe what is the volume in terms of million hectometers. On x-axis you can see what is the time period, time interval from 1962 as well as 1972. So let us assume we have drawn the mass inflow curve, and also we have plotted the demand curve also with a slope, what, 1.5 million hectometers per year, right? So that slope we have to maintain. So curve is drawn as well as demand curve is also plotted. Okay, then after that, what we have to do? You have to mark the apex points of the curves. So now let us consider we have 5 different apexes, right? They are marked with, right, mark. And also after marking the apexes, what we have to do? We have to join those apex points, like shown in the figure, T1 to T2. T1 is one tangent, which is exactly meeting the tangent. It is parallel to the tangent. So T1 is first tangent drawn at the first apex, simultaneously T2, T3, T4, so on T5. So these tangents are drawn at the apex points, maintaining parallel to the demand curve. Okay, now let us consider the tangents are also drawn, 5 tangents are drawn, right, by maintaining the slope of 1.5 million hectometers per year. Okay, now after this, what we have to do? We have to draw the vertical intercepts. So how vertical intercepts are drawn? These vertical intercepts are drawn from this point wherever you get the maximum deficiency. Now let us consider in the tangent 1, O1 is the maximum deficiency. In the next tangent, T2, O2 is the highest deficiency in that particular period. Similarly, O3, O4 and O5 deficiencies are drawn respectively. So after drawing these deficiencies, what we have to do? We have to see whichever is the maximum deficiency is there, means maximum ordinate is there in shortfall or deficiency. That particular deficiency is considered as our required storage capacity of a reservoir. Now out of these 5 ordinates, O1 to O5, which is the bigger one? So obviously it is O5. That is, the tandem is represented with AB, the last one. So here we are coming to a conclusion that O5 is the maximum deficiency and that is considered as our required storage capacity. Okay, so we need to measure what is that deficiency, what is the height of that ordinate. So it is coming as 1.6 million hectometers. So that is the deficiency. Okay, so that is the deficiency, means that is the amount of water which we need to store. So that is the required storage capacity of the reservoir, 1.6 million hectometers. So in the next slide, a clear explanation will be given. You can see here. Now, this curve you can see. As we have come to a conclusion that curve AB means the ordinate O5 is the biggest one. We have taken a portion of that. Here you can see. At A, there is a, let us assume the reservoir is full. And after A, what happens? The dry period has started. Means the shortfall has started. After A, the reservoir is full at A. After A, the dry period has started. And again, it is ending. The dry period is ending at ordinate B. Because again at B, the reservoir has to be filled, has to be full. Then only, right, it can, we can have the capacity, full reservoir capacity at this particular point B. Otherwise, the reservoir will not be filled, will not be full. Okay, so at A, after A, that is the starting of dry period, and at B, it is the ending of dry period. So in between these, the maximum ordinate is given with this one, O5. Okay, so this is how we need to calculate, right? Okay. Now that is about this particular calculation of estimation of storage capacity for a reservoir. Okay. Now let us quickly revise what we have discussed till now. So till now what we have discussed, we have, I'll go to the first slide. Now, what is given? It is mentioned clearly that seasonal values of, season inflow values of different years are given for 12 years. So in each year we have 3 different seasons and 3 different cumulative inflow values are given. And we have assumed that those values, right? So in the problem it is mentioned that you have to maintain a storage of 475 cubics per year, right? So that we have to meet that requirement. So here what we have done, a calculation of, right? We have done a calculation on this one, right? Monsoon season 107 is the number of days, whereas 1050 is the cubic values. So these cubics, you need 1050 cubics, you need to convert it into what? You have to convert this into cubic meters per day. For that, you need to multiply with 86,400. And this is for not only for one day, it is, the flow is for 107 days. So again, this you will need to multiply with 1050 with 86,400 with 107. Then you will be getting the values in terms of cubic meters per day. Now this cubic meters per day, you need to convert into million hectometers. So to convert million hectometers, what you need to do? You need to multiply this, you need to divide this value with 10,000 first to convert it into hectometers. Then after that, after converting into hectometers, you need to divide with 10 lakhs. Then that will be converted to million hectometers. So same procedure will be opted for the remaining also. So after that, what we need to do? We need to calculate the accumulated values as shown here. So accumulated value is 29.5 4570. So after calculating the accumulated values of inflow, what we have to do? You have to calculate the demand curve also. The demand curve, how it is calculated? Yearly demand is calculated. So yearly demand is equal to 365 days into what is the storage we have to maintain? 475 cubics. So 365 into 475 into 8.64. So directly it will be converted into what? Hectometers. Hectometers per day. So after converting it into hectometers, divide with 10 lakhs, million hectometers will be there. So this is your 1.5 is your demand. So now after this, what we need to do? You need to plot the graph. Curve is plotted as well as demand curve is also formed. After forming the mass inflow curve, what we need to do? You need to assume, you need to mark the apex points. So after forming the apex points, you need to draw a tangent along with apex points by maintaining the slope as demand. So whatever the demand is there, exactly parallel to that, you have to draw the tangents. So let us assume 5 tangents are drawn, T1, T2, T3, T4 and T5. So here T5 is the biggest tangent. So obviously the ordinate will be maximum. So here we got AB. So ordinates O1, O2, O3, O5. So out of this, O5 is the maximum one. So that we can decide that is the our required storage capacity. Okay, so that is given as 1.6 million hectometers. So this is how you have to calculate the storage capacity required for a reservoir for a given particular inflows. Okay, so that's all for now. Thank you so much.